I was always told that my first love was film. I come from a family of old movie fanatics, photographers, and directors, and I think that's the reason I am the way I am. We had a really small television box in my dad's room when I was growing up, and I would sit on the carpet and rummage through a closet dedicated to video cassette tapes.
Always wearing red, always drinking coffee, always smoking a cigarette. I thought it meant something at first, her being there. Maybe she was waiting for someone. Maybe she was waiting for me. Sometimes I'd smile at her. Others, I'd consider approaching her. And I'd always, always stare. And one day, she was gone. I never saw her again. Soon after that, I left the city, started college, got a job, an apartment, met a girl. Sometimes, you know, when things get a little too, I think of her. I think of woman. She never makes it fully go away, but that's the closest to peaceful I've ever felt, and that's okay.
Can you believe at this time yesterday we were in English class? No.
My grandparents' old house where my mother grew up. A child of seven, there were plenty of rooms filled with massive beds and countless space. But with just my mother and I there, it was hauntingly silent. The air was so thick, I felt like I could drink it. It suffocated me, intoxicated my actuality. And suddenly, my existence no longer revolved around my friends, whom I was blatantly forced to leave behind. My existence now solely consisted of waking up every day, going to school, coming home, alone. homework, watching television, eating dinner was all done in solitude. My mother worked late hours and often didn't get back until I was already asleep. I don't know how that much isolation hadn't driven me to insanity. I was certainly very lonely though, but according to my mother, I just had to deal with it. So I did, in my own exceptional way, by avoiding the house, for its emptiness overwhelmingly reflected my own. Before and after school, I went anywhere I could in reasonable distance. Time passed quicker that way.